The thoughts, views, and opinions expressed by its host and guest on this podcast is for entertainment purposes only. I express firmly I am here to have a fun time and don't need anyone ruining it by being butthurt. Take your clapped cheeks somewhere else. I am not a professional. I just play one on the show. Thank you and continue supporting. Deuces.
Yo. Yo, 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 yo. Welcome, 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 welcome back to the aftermath. Is it the aftermath of the elections? Yeah, it will be the aftermath. So let's start off with some inspirational words.
All right, because this is, well, I'm just going to speak, okay? So this is it. So you know how those lids on those Starbucks cups, they're white, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so if you wear lipstick,
oh,
they get all over the lid. And so then I find myself in meetings if I'm the only woman, and that's kind of, and so I keep taking the lid off and having my cup out so that I don't have that big lipstick mark on the lid. So I said, can we do something about the color of the lid?
That's for you guys. That's for you guys. That's for you guys that voted and lost, all right? And every rivalry, every competition, there's a winner and there's a loser. And I'm going to say the response videos of the Democrats losing is pretty fucking hilarious. Now, I'm a Democrat, all right? I've said it before. I'm a Democrat. But you would not find me making a video of me crying to the camera over this loss. So I dedicate this song to all the Democrats that are hurting right now. Yes, I'm playing music. Oh, wow, Spotify. Let me know if you know what the song this is.
Today is gonna be the day that they're gonna throw it back to you.
Hey.
By now you should have somehow realized what you gotta do. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. Backbeat, the word is on the street that the fire in your heart is out. I'm sure you've heard it all before, but you never really had it out. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. And all the roads we have to walk are winding. And all the lights that lead us there are blinding.
True.
The Democrats are having an amazing time explaining how they're feeling right now, with a lot of screaming. I'm not supposed to be playing music. I said I wasn't gonna do this, but if they're gonna give me issues on all my catalog, and I'm critiquing this music, so that's my workaround. This is amazing music. This is definitely the day after.
The most loneliest day of my life. Such a lonely day should be banned. It's a day that I can't stand.
They were so upset.
The most loneliest day of my life.
I mean, y'all weren't lonely.
The most loneliest day of my life.
You guys weren't lonely.
Such a lonely day shouldn't exist. It's a day that I'll never miss. Such a lonely day, and it's mine. The most loneliest day of my life. Oh, and if you go,
all right, all right, all right, all right. Let me stop playing around. Let me get into business. I apologize to the people that might be butthurt with me playing this music, but I don't
know. Nay, I do not jest that. I do not jest like that.
You frolic too much.
I'm just here to have a good time. Refer to the front of the tag. All right, so without further ado, let me go and hit this.
Hey, want to hear the most annoying sound in the world?
You're listening to...
No!
Special...
Characters.
And let me go and hit this one.
Welcome back to another late night with...
Jose.
Are you ready?
That's me.
Is there any way we can cut Michael?
No, we're not doing that. We're not doing that. AKA...
On my cool, J.
Welcome back, people. Good people. Man, the last 24 hours has been... hilarious to me. It shouldn't be hilarious because this is an important topic. It's a presidential debate. This does affect our lives, but the internet's always going to internet. And I must say, the internet was interneting, but real life was not real lifing as it normally does. So if you don't know what I'm talking about, which is if you guys can't tell, you I don't know how you're missing the context clues. Donald Trump just became the 47th president. Donald J. Trump, DJT, just became the 47th president. You know what? I'm going to give it up to him because that's not an easy thing to do. And it was by a landslide. I'm going to get into all of that before you guys get all pissy in your pants about what I'm going to talk about. I'm going to talk about how he became the person that he got into the seat. And it's the Democratic people's fault. It is. You're going to be like, you just said you were a Democrat. I know what I said, but the nominees, the people that were chosen, the way they moved, the way they treated us, it all comes into play. But let me get to the fun stuff. So after I woke up to the news that Donald J. Trump, what does the J stand for? Gerard? Let's see. I got time. This is going to be a long podcast. All right. It's going to get a little bit political, and I know people don't like that. Oh, well, man. There's a little fast forward button that you can hit. All right. What is Donald Trump's middle name? Donald John Trump. That was corny. Imagine it was like Jerome. That should have been fire. Donald John Trump. All right. So, woke up to the news that he became the president. I was like, I saw it coming. I've been seeing it coming. If you've been listening to this podcast or the way I've been talking about the way this race has been going, it's been one-sided. So, I already knew that this man was going to win. The fact that people were naive, delusional, to think that they were... that the Democrats were gonna win was fucking crazy. It's crazy. And I can't even put all the blame on Kamala Harris because she was just thrown into the race. All the blame goes in to everybody else that was seated. Everybody else in the committee that felt that Joe Biden was the best candidate to go against this man again. No. You needed somebody stronger. It wasn't Joe Biden. And it definitely wasn't Kamala. That poor woman got thrown into this shit and she got her ass whipped. You ever seen that MMA video of that big dude with the two girls? That's basically what happened. She was getting washed this whole time. She had one good hit, one good debate where he kind of was a little shaky. But then, what do they call those? It was a knockout. Clear knockout. There was no decision cards. It went straight to... we knew who was going to win, all right? That's all it was. This was like a clear knockout. So as I was stating, this to go around didn't hit the same way that it did the last time. See, the last time when Donald J. Trump was elected, the first time I was in the office, the tensions were high. The air was thick with so much tension, you could cut it with a knife. And rest in peace to my homie Jimmy, because he was a huge Donald Trump supporter since day one. And he always made me laugh because people used to look at him crazy, because at the time to be a Latino supporter for Trump was crazy because of the way he was handling the situation with us. So it was pretty funny that I would always hear him, because I've always said your political views are your political views. I might not agree with it, but I could respect your political views, all right? And I would expect the same vice versa. Now, what it came down to was the very first go around, My man comes into work. He got his MAGA hat on. He's strutting in the office. He's like, but he's joking around. Everything's in jest, the same way I make fun. So he was like, you see this, ladies? And the girls are, and they're like, how dare you? How could you? Kind of like the way it's going right now. If you voted for Trump, where is it? Because I saw a couple of good ones. And they had me crying. Where is it? Because it was just people being hurt. Can I play this? Stop playing.
Here.
Yeah.
Get here. How did we get here?
Hearing this
what
all day.
What in the Alice in Wonderland nightmares is going on right
jokes.
Now?
All I can say is how fucking dare you.
If you voted for that man, if you voted for anybody other than Kamala and you live in one of the
hearing
states
this all
that
day
was
jokes.
You know, close.
And I'm a Democrat.
If you didn't vote.
I found this shit funny.
Fuck you.
It's not going to happen. This girl was crying. This is how it was the first go around.
I chose family. I chose women. I chose America. I love you.
Get here.
Relax. Relax. There was more. There was way more. So, hearing that after this, I was like, yo, see, I'm gonna get to that later. That's a little pinpoint for me later down the line in the cool report. But hearing that all day made me laugh. I was like, oh my God, we're such sore fucking losers. We're sore losers, but not as bad as the other team the last go around. But yeah, when I went to work, it was a bunch of that. I saw that in person and it took everything in my soul not to break out laughing, because it's the same conversation that it was the last time. And the thing is, when it comes to this talk of there's racism and there's silent racism, right? So I always laugh because there's a lot of Democrats that are like racist, but are undercover racist. And they tend to show themselves every now and then. Because even when my first day back, coming back to work, some lady was like, I didn't think I was going to see you today. I'm like, excuse me? Yeah, I didn't think I was going to see. I was like, it's not same day shipping, bro. Like, what are we talking about? I was like, I'm legal, born here, born in the USA. So it was crazy for a lot of people, even the first go around, to assume that I was going to go get sent back. I was like, to Queens? I know I'm in Long Island, but I don't think they're going to deport me back to Queens. I was like, that shit was crazy. And they also brought the funny hashtag that I saw, which was jokes all day. If you go look it up, white dudes for Kamala. That had me crying, yo. I was like, why is that a hat? Why can't it be men for Kamala, guys for Kamala? It was specifically white dudes for Kamala. Way to make it about race right there. Like, that made no goddamn sense to me. So I was like, all right, whatever. But, yeah. This go around in the office, it wasn't the same. It was quiet. It was somber. It was kind of like the music I was playing. Everybody was like mourning silently. And I was like, oh, this isn't fun. I'm like, this is not fun. I came here for the over dramatics. I came here for all this stuff. So it was just jokes. And then, like, there's such, you know why it sucks to talk about politics sometimes? Because not that people are so passionate about shit. Because a lot of the times, if you're probably watching this, you're super political. You're probably, you don't know what the fuck you're talking about at the time too. I get that. But there was people that wanted to support Trump, but couldn't support Trump because follow their social media, and it will be like a whole conversation in the office. Because even I got shit. At one point, people thought I was a Trump supporter, and I was like, no, it's not that I'm a Trump supporter. Is that the Democrats are doing so fucking bad and I'm so pissed off and I'm listing all the things that they're fucking up in that it looks like I'm fucking changing sides. No, 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 no. I'm from Queens. If you don't know that, Mets fan. I've been backing losers my whole fucking life. Okay. So yeah, I'm probably going to get shit for that too. But it was just funny just being in the office. So yeah, seeing people hide their like their MAGA hats. I was like, because there was one girl I worked with, Puerto Rican girl, made me laugh. And she was like, oh, who are you voting for? Like tiptoeing, like to see what I'm going to say. And she looked like she wanted to be like, oh, I'm voting for Trump. And she thought I was going to go, oh my God, how could you vote for such? Your choice is your choice. All right. Whether you made the choice on your own or you're just following what your friends are doing, that's your God-given choice. That's something I'm never going to argue with anybody. I almost didn't vote this going around. I almost did not vote. And then I thought about, nah, I can't do that because people have fought for that right for me to vote. Soldiers have fought for my right for me to vote. I look like a dickhead if I don't go vote. And the other things that were important for me to vote on, which I lost in those too, were the propositions that they were given. The propositions 1 through 6. See, I voted for everything except for one. And if you're a feminist, you're like, oh my God, how could you? How could you vote no against that? And there was little side stipulations added to that proposition that I did not agree with. And it was like, all right, save, how can I put this? Save a few and harm the many. It's like, all right, I'm doing a good deed for this one group, but I'm fucking over this whole other group of people. So that was a very difficult decision. I was in the polling booth, Googling like, all right, what are the real fine print of Proposition 1? What is the real fine print of Proposition 2, Proposition 3? And I was like, all right, yes, no, hell no. And it was like, all right. So I found that like the presidential shit was important, but those propositions were way more important than who to really vote for. I already knew that me voting for Kamala wasn't going to be a winning recipe. It wasn't going to be a winning recipe. But I could try because I wanted to see an outcome, because there was this theory going on. It's not really, I don't know, would you consider it a theory about the 4 years that you're in? You're kind of like, if you're not cleaning up somebody else's mess, you're taking credit for somebody else's work. So I wanted to see something. That's why I really voted. So I was like, okay, let's see if this is true or not. Because and we'll never know because this guy won. But yeah, it was like something that I wanted to like really invest and look into, if that makes any sense to you guys. But yeah, I wasn't supposed to start off like this. Not at all. Now, what I will say is that on my way to the polls, I got to give it to you Trump people. You Trump people show up. That's good for y'all. You guys are really standing in what you believe in. Because these two men went to my area, right? If they were from the area, they should have knew better, but they came down to my area. Yes, you could voice whatever you want. Go ahead. Freedom of speech. But what you're not going to do is go down to an area that's heavily populated with immigrants. You're going to be like, what do you mean by that? Everybody's not legal? Yes, they're legal, but a good chunk of people in my neighborhood are immigrants that aren't really fully documented, or they live with somebody that's documented illegally. This is Queens, all right? It's always been like this in Queens. And then, as I mentioned before, the refugee camps are here. They're here. So these two guys came down here like, All they had to say, people, was vote for Trump, keep illegal immigrants out. That's it. If you want to save America, vote Trump, and we can stop all these illegal immigrants from entering. That's all you got to say. Don't show up to the area and be like, amen, vote for Trump, and get these fucking people the fuck out of here. That shit was crazy, bro. The pointing, you get out of my country. That shit had me like, oh, okay. You guys are doing something different. Okay, that's really aggressive. Because if you guys haven't noticed the results, a lot of people of color, a lot of Latinos voted for Trump. All right. This is the first time. I think this is the first time I've ever seen New York look like a goddamn red state. New York City look red. If I'm correct, let me check my sources. I'm pretty sure New York was red. Yeah, red. Yeah, that's crazy. I ain't never see that. New York has always been blue. And then this is the first time I've ever seen it red. That's wild shit. That's wild shit. Let me just check one more thing. Yeah, voted red. Yeah. Voted red. That's crazy, son. That's some crazy shit. I ain't never seen that. That's what I'm talking about. When they said they fucked up. The Democratic Party fucked up. That has never been a thing. That has never really ever been a thing where New York has been red. That's crazy. So, yeah. I wasn't supposed to talk about this subject right away. I was supposed to take my sweet-ass time off. I was supposed to talk about other things. But fuck it, we're here. So, I want to know after this, thank God the election's over, all right? Everything's done, everything's sealed. I want to know who I can sue. Who can I sue over the massive, annoying texts I received during the election? What data breach was there that all of my numbers were given to these people to spam me all day? Spam me all day. The whole goddamn day. No, the whole last 3 weeks, every fucking day, about the election, who to vote for. I want to know who can I sue, because that was the most annoying thing ever. I was getting so pissed off because I kept reporting it as junk, delete, reporting it as junk, block, reporting. It just kept coming in. And it was like really like personal, because it was like, hey, man, you did not vote in the last election. Who the fuck told you that information? Who told you that shit? I didn't. I did not vote the last time. And it was like, all right. That's another conversation for later, because that was a fun topic too to talk about. But yeah. I was like, yo, how did I just massively, like, I felt like every day, and then every text message. All right, so I stay with my AirPods in. Every time I received one of those text messages, it was like, hey, man, if you go vote for this, do this with the vote. You should go vote for this person, vote for that person. Do you know this is happening here, and this is why you should vote? And every time it rang off of my AirPods, I'm like, yo, shut up, Siri, shut up. And it wouldn't stop. It would play out the whole damn message. So I want to know who I can sue, because I know I can't be the only one that was getting spammed like that, because I was getting spammed like crazy, son. And I feel like the phone company should find out who is responsible for that, or which phone company are we suing for that? Because I feel like that was definitely a data breach. Like, to go like, hey, man, we looked at your political records. You haven't voted is fucking crazy. That was like, whoa. Excuse me. And I'm like, also, you're bothering me about like presidential shit. I'm like, I vote on other things, assholes. Like, what the fuck? I was like, yo, I was like, you see that basketball court in the middle of the worst neighborhood ever? Yeah, me. I voted for that. All right. It's terrible at night. But in the morning, just watch where you step. But yeah, that had me getting, like, I was like, yo, what is going on? Like, why is this a thing? So, yeah. Who can we sue? Comment down below, 1-800-233-9797. Now, I want you to comment the number, all right? I'm not telling you to call the number. I want you to comment, spam that number in the comment section. Why? It doesn't do nothing for me, but why not? So, yeah, all right, let's get out of this. So, I know I'm not going to get, I'm going to get flagged for this beginning of this episode. I'm going to get all these things. And I find myself thinking of new ways for this show. Thinking of new things to do. Thinking of new segments. Probably scrapping all the segments and coming up with something different. Something new. All right. And the best way for you to do things, guys, if you ever want to see, if you ever have a hobby that you're doing, if you want to see if you ever made improvements, whether you're drawing, writing, I don't know, what other hobbies are there? Building, creating, whatever. If you ever want to see how you're doing, I want you to look back at your old work, and that's going to be the gauge. See, I wore this pink shirt for a reason. And if you want to know why, this podcast started in 2020. It's 2024. I went to go watch the first episode. Terrible. Terrible. It was terrible. I don't know how we were thinking when we did the first episode. But I believe it was called How I Met Your Potter. And it was a 30-minute episode. 30-minute episode of just randomness. Shout out to C's, because without us doing that work, I wouldn't be able to fine-tune the show the way it is now. And now I want to keep fine-tuning it. Because watching that, we had skits. We were just a mess. Like, we didn't have structure. We didn't have order. We didn't have anything. It was just, all right, really random. All right. So he would be like, hey, man, how was your day? I was like, how about we tell him how we met? And I'm like, wait. And I'm listening to this now with my podcast ears, and I'm like, wow, this is hard to hear. I feel bad for my friends that were lying to us, saying that episode was good. That episode was terrible. You guys should have told us to stop a long time ago. Yo, guys over here giving false hope. Like, oh, no, you guys got something there. We did not. We did not have something at all. So looking at those episodes, I was like, wow, this is like, all right. And then you can see, like, all right, the structure slowly coming in. You can see, all right, we're tuning this. We're fixing this. Me and him building chemistry. And I was like, all right. And then watching all of us, like, work together. When I say all of us, I mean me and my friends and family. Just all working together. It was like, all right. And then the way it ended up, where it's like, all right, now it's me now. And it's like, okay, now I have this section. It's no longer random. This is random, but there's not as bad. It's organized randomness. So I was like, all right. So now I'm looking at this and I'm like, all right, I'm about to go into the fifth season. The fifth season is here. And each season that I dropped has only 34 episodes, 30 to 34 episodes. And I'm like, I'm past that. I'm getting close to hitting 40 episodes for this season, which is amazing, because this is like one of the first times where there's no abrupt stop. Like, something didn't happen where the show had to come to a stop, or the mid-season finale took way longer for me to come back. So it was like, all right, I normally stop around January and then take like a couple of months off so I could figure out what to do. So that's what I'm focusing on now, because that deadline is getting close. And I'm like, all right, what else can I do? Because there's always room for improvement. So now I'm trying to figure out what more can I tweak? What better can I do? If I should get more animated with this, if I should start doing little PIPs right here when I'm showing like little videos to you guys, where I'm playing audio for you guys to see. I'm trying to figure out all these things for me to do to get you guys to engage more. So it's very entertaining, because I got asked a real question, and it's a new listener that I know. She just started listening to my shit, and she goes, do you feel that you're sacrificing a lot to do this show? Because she was looking at the YouTube numbers. I was like, yo, don't look at the YouTube numbers. The YouTube numbers will make you think that my show isn't doing as good as it's doing. The YouTube numbers will make you think like I'm doing really terrible. I was like, you're looking at the wrong thing. You can't look at yet. I was like, but my Spotify numbers are good. My Spotify numbers is what gives me hope to like think that I'm doing something out here. So I'm like, all right. But yeah. So I was like thinking like, all right, what else can I do? Because now it's about to be 5 years of this. And I'm like, all right, I need something to show. Now I need something to show for me doing this for 5 years. I need there to be a great outcome out of this. As I mentioned before, the awards, I lost my awards. They were trying to find other ways to like make me feel better, but I was like, nah. I lost one of the podcasters running. What did I apply for? Up-and-coming podcasters. I lost that award. So I was like, all right, this is okay. They notified me again today. I totally forgot about it, and they notified me again today. So I was like, all right, this is what's sparking this conversation that I'm having with you guys, where I'm like, all right, what else can I do? Clearly, they saw something that they didn't like. And the conversation that I keep getting that I feel it's holding me back, because I need to like do like a whole 360 on this character that I do with you guys, because it's technically not brand friendly. And now I was just literally watching a video of this kid that I watch, and he's having the same conundrum that I'm having, except he's more successful in the field right now, but he's dealing with the same thing that I'm dealing with, where we have to appear brand friendly and have to make this a household name. This is going to be hard to do because a lot of my content is like, whoa, like, why would you say that? Why would you go here? Or like, I'll say something that I shouldn't have said. And it's like, oh God. So it's just something that I have to now be conscious about, which is going to be crazy for me to really like reel this in. But yeah, so that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to start looking for more tuning for this show before the new season starts. Now, let's get out of this section and go into the movie review section. And I just want to say, this isn't a movie that I saw, but it's a trailer that I saw and I kind of want to see, because I hate commercials for trailers. Not the trailer, commercials for the trailer. Like, it's like the new thing that they do now is like, they interview the actor that's in it to talk about the character that they're doing, and they make that the trailer for the movie instead of putting out a trailer. So this is one of the things I was talking about. I was like, all right, this will make more sense for me to make a PIP for you guys to listen to. Now, the name of this movie is called Aurora. Did I save it? No, they got rid of it. That's so annoying. All right, so the name of this film is called Anora.
Unturned. I wanted to know this character, like, inside and out completely.
Well, this is the beautiful Annie.
So I did months of dance training. I went to live in Brighton
Beach. This movie's
Beach.
About a stripper.
I wanted to get a sense of the community. And then also I wanted to visit clubs. It was sort of just about learning the etiquette, what the dancers go through. And so I watched the girls and talked to consultants as well.
Do you see the way they're trying to market this?
The accent a little bit. Once you give me health insurance, workers' comp, and a fucking 401k, then you can tell me when I work and not work. I bought a couple pieces of the costume for my character, made Pinterest boards for how I wanted her to look, and I read memoirs to get into character. I've never quite done this.
Who the fuck wrote a stripper memoir? What does that entail? Is better. No, Brittany Renner wrote a tell-all, which I would assume is the same as a stripper memoir. Like, oh, you know, I'd be dancing on dudes' laps and we talk about the first thing that pops up. Like, so I'm watching the trailer, which is in the trailer, is the interview. They took the interview and made it the trailer for the movie. And I'm like, I'm watching this and I'm looking at this girl, and this girl looks really ambiguous, right? She looks Asian, but she's not Asian. So the name of the girl that was just talking, her name is Mikey Madison. Now, you're like, Mikey Madison, that's a boy's name. I'm like, I said the same thing too. But watching her, I'm like, I've seen her, but I can't tell who she is. And I'm like, she looks Asian. She looks Asian to me. And I'm reading the comments. I'm like, yo, why is everybody writing that this girl looks Asian? She's clearly Jewish. And I'm like, no, you're bullshitting with me. I've seen her or something. And it was a Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. If you're wondering, the girl that I'm talking about, she's the girl that charges at Brad Pitt and gets the dog food can thrown to her face and it breaks her nose. That girl looks Asian to me. So I was like, she's not? So I'm like fucking freaking out. I was like, wow. I was like, you sure? You sure about that? You sure about that? So I'm watching the trailer for this and I'm like, this is a lot. Like, you guys did a whole lot of nothing. See, this girl was like, I went to Brighton Beach. Is that where they're at? Is that where all the strippers live? And she was like, I did a Pinterest board to make outfits. I did this. Bitch, you could have called Cardi B. Cardi B just did a movie. You could have just watched, what's the name of that movie with Cardi B and J-Lo? Damn, what the hell was the name of that movie? Was it called Shooters or some shit like that? Strippers? Scammers? Cardi B, J-Lo movie. Hustlers. You know, when Cardi B was portraying to like drug men so they could take their money, and they just turned it into a character, and Hollywood was like, oh, that's totally fucking fine. that's good. So, yeah. Hustlers. Because when it's okay to rob men and drug them, as long as it's all in good fun. And Cardi B's going, a-kurt. All right. And J-Lo's there, like, messing up, de-shuffling her hair. I don't know. You know what it is? It's just I'm tired of seeing movies trying to glorify these stripping movies. You know who took a crazy turn with their acting career? Emma Stone. She's been playing roles where she's getting slutted out. And I'm like, I don't mind watching this. But at one point, I'm like, yo, are you okay, sis? Like, are you doing okay? Because she did some movie where I couldn't tell. Like, she was like a sex robot. And fucking Mark Ruffalo was like fucking having the time of his life with her. They're fucking the robots. That was like a premonition here to come. And then she did some other show or movie with the kid from Like Mike, the bully from Like Mike. And this lucky bastard's over here tag teaming Emma Stone and Ethan Hawke's daughter. And I'm like he's like, blah, blah, blah. Gosh, shorty, have Ethan Hawke's poor daughter giving her the guac guac. Like, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, I don't get the premise of this movie, but I like watching it. And I'm like, it made me mad because I was like, all right, there, all right, Emma Stone's like a strong six, all right? But Ethan Hawke's daughter, whatever her name is, she's like an 8 or 9. I was like, and you ramming both of them? In what world? In what world? In what world? Why am I not doing better? But yeah, I'm over here watching this trailer for this movie that's coming out. She's like, I took dancing classes. You mean a twerk class? I took dancing classes, like, to understand what's going on. And I'm like, you could just go to the gym, the local YMCA, take a twerk class. You didn't have to, like, sign for the most exclusive, inclusive twerk class there is. And hopefully you picked the right twerk class. Hopefully you picked the right pole class. All right? She should have been down in Atlanta watching the girls go crazy over there. If she went to like some random strip club, yeah, this movie's gonna bomb. If I don't see Mickey Madison on the ceiling popping pussy, then what is the purpose of the movie? There is no purpose, all right? With her New Jersey accent. Like, come on. That wasn't like a Florida, that wasn't like a Cali accent. That was strictly Florida. But I was over here watching that trailer. I was like, I'm going to watch it because I support women, all right? Brown dudes for strippers. That's me, okay? So it's time to go to the...
We interrupt this program for an important news announcement.
All right, see? I'm going to save you guys. I'm going to save you guys because President Trump is on the docket list. But I'm going to give the other two subjects some play, because if I do the Trump stuff now, somebody's gonna get offended and they're gonna miss the other two topics because they're pretty good topics. So a rival Neuralink company has just restored the sight in a person's eyes. Yo, relax, ho. So all right, where is it? Implant restored vision in a blind person for the first time in history. That's amazing. That's amazing. That's amazing. See, this was a Neuralink. It was the rival of Neuralink. And I've been saying to you guys that Neuralink is doing big things. So there's a company. Yo, shut your mouth. All right. What was the name? Prima. Prima, which has restored the vision of a legally blind patient. The innovation implants works by converting light patterns into electrical signals that the brain interprets as images, allowing trial participants to regain enough vision to read, recognize faces, and even play cards. Designed to tackle vision loss from advanced age-related macular degeneration, Prima can mark a transformative breakthrough in retinal prosthesis technology, offering a new hope to individuals affected by severe visual impairment. That sounds amazing. That sounds amazing, guys. I don't know. You know what? Here, where is it? Where is it? That's for those guys. The robots are here. No, this is what I'm talking about. See, people want to argue with me all the time when I start mentioning technological advances. When I say, when I tell you guys, look at me, look at me, look at me. I will be one of the first people that try to do cybernetic upgrades, starting with the NBOs. Yeah, that's on my bucket list, all right? I will be technologically taller, all right? Taller, all right? You know what it makes me think of? It makes me think of the show Superman, The Adventures of Superman, right? And there's this episode where this guy named is Michael Corbin, right? And he gets tricked into doing a full body transformation, right? He's able to upload his consciousness into a robot, and now he has a robot body. See, this reminds me where I don't want to be the first person to take their consciousness and put it into a robot, if that makes any fucking sense. All right. So in this episode where he he wakes up, he doesn't even get to see the robot that he's going to become. He just gets told, we're going to take your consciousness with it here, blah, 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 blah. They tell him the false pretenses that, like, hey, man, feeling things, eating, breathing, like, it's all temporary. All right. You don't need to worry about that right now. They didn't tell him that it was permanent. All right. That they told him that they're going to make adjustments. They told him that adjustments have to be made later down the line. And they took it as like, all right, they're going to fix it. But what they didn't say to him was like, no, you mentally have to get past it and make your own adjustments. You have to adjust to not having these feelings, sensations, taste, and all this stuff anymore. That's what you got to deal with. So, yeah. But that would be like more on the like, oh shit, negative side, as opposed to imagine losing your vision. Imagine losing your vision and never having your vision and now you're able to see. That shit is crazy, son. Like, I was just having a conversation about the organ donation list, and I'm an organ donor, and I was talking about things that I would give away. See, I can't give away my kidneys are done, but what I can't give away my liver because my livers are done. I can't give away my lungs are done. What the fuck can I give away? I can't even give my eyes away if I really wanted to because they're going to have astigmatism. God, there is nothing that... Why am I an organ donor now that I'm thinking about it? Oh, you know one of the things they ask you for from when you die and you're already an organ donor and they could take your heart, your liver, all these things? They ask for skin. I think that's a wild thing to ask for. To ask for skin is a wild thing to ask for. How much skin are you taking? Where are you taking the skin from? That's an even better question. I would assume it's your back, right? Like, don't take skin from nowhere important. Like, don't take it, like, away from my neck. Oh, does that work with people that have tattoos? Can people that have tattoos still make skin donations? Then you got, like, a random dragon patch on your back. Like, imagine, like, somebody has, like, they take the skin from, like, somebody's back and they have, like, a full dragon tattoo. And they take that skin and put it on somebody's face. I'm like, ah, right there. That shit is crazy. But back to what I was saying. Imagine I donate my eyes. Like, you're a blind person. You ain't never seen shit before. And you get my eyes. And it's like, shit, I got to wear glasses now for the rest of my life. Oh, man, I already wore shades for the first 30 years of my life. I got to wear glasses now for the rest of it? That sounds inconsiderate, but hey, whatever. Like, that's a huge strive, guys. If we're able to send electrical signals to make images from your eyes to your brain, that's fucking pretty amazing, son. Because it always freaks me out when I hear people are born deaf. And I'm like, what does the little voice in your head sound like? Does it just sound like screaming? And then you're like, oh, I understand exactly what he's saying. I understand those tones of scream. Because if you never heard words before, if you never heard English or whatever language, like language in general, if you never heard language in general, what the hell are you thinking? How can you make words up in your mind? Like, one of my favorite things to see on Instagram is this girl. She fucks with her sister. And she was like, can you tell me? Her sister's deaf. She was like, can you tell me what this would sound like? So she'll go like this. And she's like, And I'm like, close, close, very close, very close. And then she'll be like, go to, like, other things. And she just makes the most weirdest noise. And it was like, I have to assume that the thought, the little voice in your head, isn't giving the proper, isn't giving you the proper information to process shit. So it's like, all right, if you're deaf and you learn sign language, right? And you're like, all of this, do you see like a little person in your head doing sign language and that's the way you communicate? Does that make sense? Is that too much? Am I fucking doing too much? But yeah, that's crazy, son. That is crazy. Shout out to that company once again. For making these strides. Tesla, it should have been you. Not Nikola Tesla. Elon Musk, it should have been you. It should have been you guys over there following the campaign trail with that man. Boosie asked Donald Trump to grant him a pardon. Boosie, fuck out of here. You were not supporting that man. Boosie asked Donald Trump to pardon. The nerve of that bitch. All right, let's see. So, in hip-hop news, Plies is suing Megan Thee Stallion. He's suing... Hold up. Soulja Boy, Megan Thee Stallion, and Glorilla, because they used a beat that sounds familiar. See, this is the exact argument that I'm having right now with YouTube and Spotify, because I think there's eventually, if I keep doing playing music and shit like that, not just the playlist in the beginning, music in general. If I ever want to review music like I did with the J. Cole, and they flagged the hell out of me for that one, they was like, you don't have the rights to this, and blah, 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 copyright, you cannot monetize. They gave me all these red walls. They stopped me from putting my YouTube video out in multiple places. That shit was crazy. And then 2 months later, Spotify threatened to take down the majority of my videos that had music in it. And it's like, wait, hold up. You guys still get play off of this because it's on your platform. Like, what are we talking about? So it was a crazy, crazy, crazy thing. But Ply suing them, I get it, especially if that's your music. So let's see. But a producer came out and he was like, yo, your song wasn't even the song that everybody's sampling, if that makes any sense. I'll play that later. So yeah, suing for copyright infringement. So this is the song. I keep a couple killers around me when I'm killing. Cause don't really fuck with a lot of these dudes. I never heard a Ply song in my life. But I might rob me. Alright. Soldier. I fuck with soldiers though. All the pretty girls stand up. All the pretty girls stand up. I fuck with soldiers song heavier. This right here is my sweat. Hey. All the girls. Soldier. I'll let it pump again. All the pretty girls stand up. All the pretty boys stand up. Pretty boys stand up. This right here is my sweat. Hey. All the girls. Soldier. And this is Megs. He in love with Glow. Never got the cook, but got my name tatted. Killer word, don't know who he killed. I heard that main ready. Never full. When it's time to eat, I be his main platter. So, Plies, I don't think you can sue, because I would think that's more of the producer thing to sue, not you. I don't think they're using your lyrics or using any of them. Maybe a little bit of the flow, but I don't know. I don't think you could sue. I think your DJ, your producer could sue. But they're saying that, for the record, Pretty Boy Swag is a remake of My Dougie as well. Soulja Boy is on the My Dougie remix. What the hell is the My Dougie? Is that Teach Me How to Dougie, right? No. My Dougie. Let's see. It's a biggie beat. My Dougie, my Dougie, my Dougie. Yeah. My Dougie, my Dougie, my Dougie, my Dougie. She say she like my Dougie. I'm fresh, my Dougie. I'm fresh, my Dougie. I'm fresh. Plies, you cannot do that. You cannot sue over something that you didn't even fucking create. What the fuck is Plies talking about? That's a bullshit money grab, sir. You need to cut it. Because that was a weak-ass attempt to get some money off of that. Lil Will should sue the shit out of you for suing them, trying to get money off of that. If I'm Lil Will, I'm letting you do all the leg walk for me, all the walking for me, all the running, opening the doors, the windows, so I could come in the back end and sue the fuck out of you for all the money that you want. Because how are you going to say that they took your shit when you took somebody else's shit? That's fucking crazy, son. That's some wild shit. I'm a little, well, I'm jumping your ass. Knocking them fucking big ass teeth out your mouth. Fucking crazy as shit. You can't do that, Plies. You can't do that. You can't take credit for something that you had no parts in. Like, what did you do? Like, you know what you should do? Oh, yeah, that looks... We should slow down the tempo. Can I do that? I think I could do that. Hold up. I mean, I'm already in the doghouse. I might as well just do it. So... But I didn't even know... Because I think Soulja Boy was on the remix, if I'm correct. All right.
It's a biggie beat.
My Dougie, my Dougie, my Dougie, my Dougie, my Dougie, my Dougie, my Dougie. She say she like my Dougie. I'm fresh, my Dougie. I'm fresh, my Dougie. I'm fresh, yep. Flyin' them Dougie. My Dougie, my Dougie.
All right, just slow it down.
My Dougie, my Dougie, my Dougie, my Dougie. She say she like my Dougie. I'm fresh. My Dougie, I'm fresh. My Dougie, I'm fresh. Yep.
That's all you did. That's all you guys did. You guys just did that. You guys didn't even do. You guys didn't even add nothing extra to it. You guys just slowed it down. The nerve. The nerve. The nerve. Oh man! Shout out to TikTok for taking my video for something. So the newest copyright infringement that I'm getting is now movies, cartoons are now stepping in for sound effects. So. One of these days, I won't be able to play none of these noises for you guys. Because the first time I experienced this was with Michael Jackson's Thriller laugh. That one. That right there got me super copyrighted infringement for me using that 6-second clip. So that's the newest thing. Because I found YouTube giving me an issue with this one. They that's all I played was the
Wait, Jose.
And they went, not YouTube, TikTok came and they removed my audio off my shit. So I'm like, and that's what makes me mad with TikTok, because TikTok doesn't just remove the section, they remove all of the damn audio. So it's just a useless video of me just going. Y'all don't stop fucking playing with me. But yeah. That shit was annoying to see that. But yeah, man. Now let's jump into the presidential debate. Not the debate. Elections. Where Donald Trump has won once again. Shout out to him for keeping women down. Oh man, that's shit. When I saw that today, I was fucking in tears. Cause he dead ass was like, every time he's went against a girl, he fucking mollywopped him the fuck out of here. Hillary did not stand a chance. Not a chance. Not one chance. And here comes Miss Harris trying her bestest with 2 months of running, thinking that she was going to win. That shit was crazy. So shout out to Donald J. Trump. Shout out to the Republicans that voted for him, and all his supporters, because you guys clearly are the winners out of this outcome. So shout out to you guys. Am I upset? No, I'm not upset. I'm not even being sarcastic when I say congratulations to you guys. I'm being dead ass serious. Congratulations to you guys. I want to see how this 4 years goes. I need to see how this 4 years goes. And what's going to be crazy is that they're saying all of these things transpired and it's only his second day. But I'm like, how much are you guys glazing in this conversation? See, how much of this can I actually believe is factual for me to be like, all right, he's really out here making changes. That's what's drawing me off right now. Now, my one critique that I will have, my one, maybe two, but really one, is that you guys can now shut the fuck up. You guys can now shut the fuck up. There was monetization. There goes brand awareness. That's all gone. But shut the fuck up. Because this whole time, I'm watching the results the same way you're watching the results. But I heard a lot of Republicans crying that they're going to steal the election again. They're going to do this. They're going to do that. They were going to riot. We're going to take back our nation. Shut the fuck up. That's it. That's it. That's all I'm saying. Don't.
Wait, Jose.
No. All right. You guys were saying they're going to steal the election. That's all I heard out of every fucking Republican's mouth, was that they're going to steal the election. This is going to be a repeat of last time. Oh my God. This shows you now that the system is working, right? Is this not proof that your system is working? Is this not proof that if you go out and you actually fucking vote, that you can make a difference? Does that solidify it? Or are you guys going to find another thing to tell me that I'm wrong in? Because that was my biggest thing that was annoying me. Like, oh, the system doesn't work. What the fuck are you talking about? People just went out and voted. People felt passionate about what they were doing. That's why, as I just told you, I didn't vote for him, but that's how Biden got into office, right? So you're telling me if they did it for Biden, why wouldn't they do it again for Kamala? Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Like, come on. That was the biggest thing. And the second critique that I'm going to give you guys that are in power, your police people, like your sheriffs, whatever, they could shut the fuck up too. The nerve of them too, after this win, was fucking hilarious. It was like, you guys better not think that you could come down here and riot. You mean like y'all did? Do we forget about January 6th? Or what the fuck are you talking about? What are you talking about? You guys better not think that you guys can organize yourself and come down here and riot. Did you forget who you're talking to? I'll be the first one to say it. They're over here fighting amongst each other over their goddamn gender. What to identify as? You think they could fucking pull together and go hold a riot? You think they could go and storm like they did in January 6th? That is not the group. That is not the group at all. I'm telling you right now, I saw the bullshit attempt that they did, and I saw them struggle to open the fence for 15 minutes. Struggling to open a fence. You know how you open a fence that you're trying to get past? You bring a pair of fucking bolt cutters. Not one person in that group thought to do that. Not any of those unathletic people thought to just jump the gate. Jump the gate. That's what I said. I give you guys credit. When you guys want to do things, you guys could do things. But sometimes you guys just start rambling. And it's like, what the hell are you talking about? The person with the girl with the pixie haircut with the buzz cut is not the one that you think is not the one that I feel that you should worry about. It's not. Half of them don't even know how to change a fucking tire. Are you kidding me? Don't know how to change their own goddamn oil. And you're telling me that's the ones you're afraid of? That's who you think is going to storm the Capitol, storm the White House? I saw the fences you guys put up. It was crazy to see that. I'm like, that is not them. That's y'all. That's y'all. Y'all have a track record of doing that. Are you kidding me? Like, what the fuck? And before he goes, what about Black Lives Matter? I don't think they were all Democrats. I don't think so. I think it was a mixture. But that's two different things. All right? One's about, hey, man, Black people need more rights versus, hey, man, we need to go figure out who to make the president. Like, that shit is crazy, son. But back to the subject at hand. As I said, congratulations to you guys. You guys showed up. And that's what I'm talking about. It's about showing up, all right? If you don't show up, you can't complain, all right? If you don't show up in droves the way they showed up in droves, you can't complain. So That's what happened the last time. This guy was going for a second term. A lot of people were like, fuck no. Everybody showed up. Everybody showed up. Was I one of those people that showed up? No. Because I was on the same way of thinking, like, nah, this shit is rigged. He's going to fucking win again. And then guess what? He fucking lost. And I was like, all right. And here we go again. A repeat is like, all right. And I'm like, now it was different. There was a different thing. Now there was something that I'm like, okay. No, he's going to win. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. He's going to win. Because the person that they threw into the ring has been in office already. She's already there. I know a lot of fucking people like to make the cop out, like, well, she's the VP. What can she do? She can make suggestions. She's there. Hey, man, I think it's cool that we do this. Why don't you think you do this? He has dementia. You could fucking trick him. You could fucking trick. You telling me you can't trick Joe Biden? Are you kidding me? Hey, man, can you sign this? I don't think you should do it. Ask him again. Hey, man, can you sign this? Oh, yeah, sure. Why not? He's going to fucking forget what he's signing. Like, what are we talking about? It was all of these wrong moves that the Democrats did that led to their loss. Nobody had belief in them. Nobody had faith. And the best of all was nobody wanted to give them the vote that they felt they were entitled to. Unfortunately, I was doing a little self-experiment and I wanted to see something. And that's why I ended up voting Democrat. But if I didn't, I wasn't going to vote, to be honest. If those propositions weren't on the table, I was not going to go vote. I was not going to go vote if there wasn't more to the fucking election than just choosing the president. So I chose Supreme Court judges. That's what I did. I made sure I did that. A lot of people didn't even think about that. Didn't even think about that. Shit. Are you kidding me? I chose how much power the fire department can have over New York State. I chose how much power the sanitation can have over New York State. I chose all these things that were just as important as choosing the president. So that's why it was, I chose things for equal rights. I chose things for abortion. I chose things for the integration. I'm saying that wrong, right? Yeah, enter. My bad. It's late. I'm saying the right word, right? No, Mikey Madison, not you. Yeah. I was voting on the interrogation of having kids playing sports with kids that aren't by the same gender, right? I voted on all of these things. So for me, it was like, all right, I'm here. I might as well just vote to see how this shit goes. But like, as I said, I was doing my own social experiment to see if she wins, if the economy would get better because of whatever policies Joe Biden put into place, or if it would get worse because she's still running the same formula as him, right? I know that seems like the worst thing to fucking do, but that's what I wanted to see. Or the main thing was to see, because the biggest talk amongst the Democrats is that when he got into office, he was taking credit for a lot of Obama shit. So I was like, I wanted to see if that was true. And Joe Biden's getting stuck with cleaning up his mess. So the only way that I would have been able to tell is if Kamala Harris got in there and then the economy got somewhat better. But I know that's like, somebody's going to be like, no, that's a dumb way of thinking and blah, 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 blah. And I know, but I just wanted to see. That's what I wanted to do. But yeah. It was all of these things, all these fucking fake promises. It was the only coming to us in the last Hail Mary toss. Like, oh man, you guys are important again. Yeah, we're only important when it comes time for election. That's the only time we're important. That's the only time they want to talk to us. Shit. So it was very like, all right, this is one-sided. This is a landslide victory. This wasn't going to be neck and neck. I already saw it from the morning, the day before, the day of the election, when everybody went voting. Those numbers were fucking speaking volumes. And everybody's like, no, it's tied. I'm like, no, it's not. It's not tied. He's winning by a lot. Everybody's like, nah, you're crazy. I'm like, I don't know what you're looking at. She's not going to win. So here comes the next day. Yeah, we saw the results. I was like, yeah. Whooped her ass. Grabbed her right by the you know what. So, yeah. And then the next biggest thing that was a slap to the Democrats' face was her concession. Her concession speech was supposed to happen that night. That was another slap to their face. I'm sorry, to our face. It's like, all right, you lost. Go out there, go do your speech. Hey, man, we lost. We gave the best fight we could. We'll get them next time, right? That's all Democrats are waiting for. That's all they're like, all right, okay. Those little words. No, you proved exactly why you didn't get the spot. Because instead of using your brain, leaving your emotions to the side, you waited a whole extra day to be like, all right, you know, Donald Trump won. That's a slap to the face of all your followers that showed up. People that pulled up to Howard University that were thought that you were going to win, right? And then you don't come out when you lose. You don't say nothing. You don't acknowledge your own people. You should have acknowledged your people. That's exactly why your ass didn't get the fucking votes this go around. The Democrats feel betrayed. We feel forgotten and all this shit. So, yeah, that's why it ain't go your way this time. And you guys are going to struggle. You guys are going to struggle to get the trust back, the confidence, because those numbers were up. All right. Those numbers were up. And the videos that I shared with you earlier, there's like they were showing the rates and everybody's playing the blame game. Everybody's like, well, we lost because the Latinos are voting red. We lost because black men were voting red. We lost. I was like, how about y'all lost because you guys couldn't keep it a buck with us? You guys, the economy's in the shitter right now. All right. All this. I'm not even a college student. I didn't give a shit about fucking college loan forgiveness. I didn't give a shit about that. But you know who did? The people that were voting for you, and then it just kept getting put in the back burner. You were in office for 4 years, lady, and it doesn't seem like we heard a peep from you until the last 2 months when they threw you into the race. They're like, all right, Miss Kamala, you go do your thing. And yeah, that's not the way it works, unfortunately. It doesn't, you just can't show up at the last minute, bring fucking Meg Thee Stallion, Glorilla, throw all these concerts, and think that's going to be enough. It's not. It was a very poor attempt. It was terrible. Yes, I just want to say I tip my hat to you guys that went out there and voted. And the outcome is the outcome. That's what it is, all right? This is a democratic system, a democracy, as people would say. And it shows that the system works, right? At least I hope that's what you get from this, is that the system works. It's not supposed to be always towards your favor, that it's supposed to be equal, and that's the way I see it. But one thing I will walk away from this great, 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 great presidential race is that America's not like women, right? This is the second time we watched on national TV this man whoop a woman's ass, and they cheered. Stop fucking around. But yeah, man, that's all it is, man. That's all it really comes down to. The Democratic Party got to figure it out, man, because right now I feel if this man does well, if this man really gets us out of this terrible economy that we're in right now, because a lot of them are bullshitting with you. A lot of them are going, well, this is the lowest rates that America has been in, inflation and blah, 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 blah. Yeah, it doesn't feel like it. It doesn't feel like it at all. It doesn't feel good when I see movies that I grew up on and they spend the whole $30 and they have like bags and bags full of shit. And now if I go to the grocery store with $20, shit, they're charging me for going to the store with the $20 just to step in there. I can't walk out with anything. Everything's up. Everything is up. So I don't know how they're going to tell us that we're not in a recession when every American is complaining that, hey, man, shit is getting rough. Shit is getting hard. We're making hard decisions on how to feed our fucking families when we're giving away trillions and trillions of our hard-earned money, our tax money, and sending it to other people, taking care of other people. See, that's a problem. We're not putting Americans first. And that's some wild shit. That's some wild shit to me. But as I stated, if he takes us out of this decline and he starts lifting us up, I'll switch over to red. I'll become a Yankee fan. I'll switch over to the Republican side. I'll buy myself some acid wash jeans, a brown coat, and a white collar, and some really thin gold frame glasses, and I'll be out there. So, yeah. So, as I stated, shout out to you guys that voted. This is what it's about. All right. You win some, you lose some, and that's all it is. Stop looking for a fucking participation trophy and fucking voting. All right. Stop looking. I've seen every person run out to go get this sticker right here. The best one. See, I might do the PIP for that one video, because that one video that I saw had me crying, because this idiot took the sticker and stickered it in the middle of his face. He's put it on the middle of his head and he was like, I supported women. I chose American families. I did this for Kamala, white guys for Kamala. And I was like, oh, shut the fuck up. But yeah. All right. So I'm going to move out of the cool report and let's go on to. Welcome. I noticed this area is kind of getting buzz. So thank you for people that like this area too. Oh, why do you half-ass the cool report? That's very easy. You want to know why I half-ass the cool report? I know what you're talking about. So the Donald Trump shit, it's me and it's character, right? So ask me a question. Ask me a question that's directed to me, Jose Luis. The cool report has cool in the title. So that's on my cool J. That's the character. All right. So what I like to do with the cool report, where people get pissed off at, because they see me take information at face value and report it to you guys. And the reason I do that is this. That's how Americans take in information. That's how everyday folks really take in information. So I love reporting that the same way people take in information. And if you think I am joking with you guys, go share an article. Don't let them read it. Or brush up on a subject that you really know about them. Show them a little clip of somebody that's like clickbait, like a clickbaity type of thing. And see the way they respond. And tell me if it doesn't sound like the cool report. That's why I do it. That's why I love it. That's what makes it hilarious. I am not a journalist. You should not be getting your news from me. I could speak on a subject. I could be talking crazy about the subject. I can agree with the subject, not agree with the subject. I control the subject. I troll the hell out of a lot of subjects, because I refer you back to the tag at the beginning of the podcast. So a lot of the times, like, yeah, you'll hear me get serious, but when you hear me on certain topics, just sound like a complete doof, sound dumb as hell, and you're getting irritated, and you're like, why is he saying this? He doesn't know what he's saying. That's why. It's in the character. Because it's just fun sometimes. I'm not an accurate news source, all right? I am not a journalist. I never claim to be a journalist. There is nothing on any of my pages that says I'm a journalist. Instagram says I'm a personality. This says comedy. You go to Spotify, you go to YouTube, it says comedy podcast, not political. So thank you for asking that question. It was only a matter of time that somebody asked that question, because I know people get so fucking mad and I get their responses. And it's funny a lot of the times, because I was like, oh, you fell for it. And that's all it really ever is me just like, all right, I'm going to get a rise. If I'm bored, it's right now, it's like about to be, it's 2:05 in the morning. I get bored. I got these cameras. I'm going to have some fun. Since I can't go into like my group chat and mess with people, I might as well just record me bothering you guys that watch this. I appreciate you guys, still love you. But hopefully you guys understand anything that has cool in it. Yeah, that's referring to my character. The cool report is from On My Cool J, the Ask Me a Question section. It's from Jose Luis. That's why you hear.
Wait, Jose!
Versus.
We interrupt.
No. I'd be like, welcome to the cool report. right? That's the difference. There's always been the difference. I just give information at face value. Like, we ever been scrolling through Instagram? Like, oh my God, this happened. So how are we going to discuss this? In the most ignorant or informative way sometimes, it's really how I feel. It feels how I feel at the moment and how I want to tackle it. But yeah, that's why. Next question. I'm not gonna serious you guys out. We were just mad serious. Would you ever consider renting out your equipment? I saw that you were selling some of your stuff. I thought about it. I have thought about renting out my equipment, and that quickly was ruined by a girl that I rented my equipment to. See, my biggest thing, because I have a whole nother recording equipment, is I would love to rent that out. And one of the things that I, when I was recording with people, or like when I did have a co-host and we would use the equipment, is that they were all smoker friendly. And when they were smoker friendly, they would blow smoke into the microphone, not on purpose, on accident. Sometimes you're in the middle of it and it just happens, right? So I didn't want to rent out equipment to people that I know were smoker friendly, and I knew that the smoke was going to get into the microphones or get into the interface and just completely ruin my system. And then it's like, all right, what if that happens to the, on the, I'm a worst case scenario person. I was like, what if I rent it out the first day and somebody fucks it up and then I'm out money? And then I look like a dickhead if I'm like, hey man, you need to pay me back for this. But the reason I really don't rent out equipment is, where is it? My poor baby, Nikki. My poor baby Nikki. I rented out Nikki once to this girl that needed an extra camera because she normally records things off her phone. I was like, you need an extra camera? She was like, I like the way that camera records. Cool. So she left her SD card in there. I was like, all right. I saw what she recorded on my beautiful camera, on my beautiful Nikki. She was fucking herself with a cucumber. I watched the video, don't get it twisted, but I'm like, my poor camera did not need to see that. My poor camera did not need to be, and I saw the video, and it looked like it got wet. Did I lick it? Let me stop. But yeah, that's why I don't. That's why I don't rent out my equipment, because I never know what somebody else is going to do with my equipment. I don't know how disrespectful they're going to be with my equipment. So yeah. That's why I don't do it. I'll probably do it with the GoPros. The GoPros could probably take a little bit of some wetness, some water damage. It's totally fine, but not my Nikki, not my DSLRs, not my Sonya. No, hell no. But GoPros, y'all waterproof, y'all straight. But like a whole cucumber, like a whole, like, rah, 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 rah. I was like, damn, bitch, you're hurting it. She doesn't want to talk to you. Hold up. Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's why. All right. Let's see. Okay. So this is going to seem catty. This is going to seem petty. This is going to seem whatever. But I'm totally with it. I get asked, your views on the launch of two shows from pod members that are on a bigger podcast. All right. So this question is for somebody that watches the same podcast that I do. Right. And it's a beautiful question because I like this question because I was trying to figure out how can I have this conversation with it sounding like hate, and there's no way I can do it. There's no way I could do it to a certain extent. So two people that are on a bigger platform dropped their own podcast, and they thought that they could do it themselves because they see somebody else do it. That's called arrogance, people. This takes planning. This isn't one day of planning. This show right here is 7 days of straight work. This is me working, going through life. Oh, that's funny. I should write that down. I went through this. I should write that down. Oh, this came up. This looks interesting. I should take this down. What can I speak on? What can I say about this? How far can I really take this? See, this is a lot of planning. This isn't just all done in one day. Like, all right, this is the topic we're going to talk about. No. Anybody that works like that, the work shows that it was really rushed. So I mentioned in the beginning of my show Then I went back to my first episode. I saw how unorganized it was. I saw how messy it was. I saw the direction it could have went. I saw the vision. It just wasn't properly executed. So when it comes to these two shows that you're talking about, they're giving this girl a problem with her show because the first episode was only 30 minutes. Your first episode, you don't know what you're going to talk about. Your first episode, you don't know what people are interested in. You don't know how to really gauge it. You don't know anything. So 30 minutes for your first episode is not bad. I've seen Rory and Maul do it. I think the JBP did it their first time. I've did it my first time. My first episode was 30 minutes with a 10-minute skit in the beginning of it. So it was like, all right, that's not a bad beginning. What I think they get a lot of pressure from is because they're coming from a bigger platform and now they're doing their own thing and they're trying to figure it out. The other guy that did it, he was just too arrogant. He focused on the wrong things, I believe, where I think he tried to focus on more control of it instead of really being creative. I saw his set. Like, this isn't the most best set that I have right here, but you won't see this set duplicated anywhere else. You don't see really anybody that has half the things that I really have. These are drawings from like my niece and nephews. A fucking Deadpool cup. Who does that? I have my No Special Characters hat right here. I got a duck right there. I'm like, there's just random things here. Then you look at this section, my Mexican death whistle, my no fuck, my zero fuck cup, a half a punk Funko Pop, a thugged out Pikachu, and a Skeletor. This is random, really random as hell. For somebody else to duplicate this, it's going to be really difficult. Not as like it can't be done, but to really figure out the aesthetics of what I did here, of just taking my everyday life and just putting it in the background. So that's what I believe the other guy did as a mistake, where he focused too much on the wrong thing instead of being creative, and he ended up just taking shit from other people's things. And then he didn't focus on production. He didn't focus on the lineup. He didn't focus on a storyline to go with. So his show didn't seem like it was the best. It just seems like my first episode was. But the only difference was, is when I did my first episode, we weren't already podcasting. That's the biggest thing, that we weren't already doing this. We didn't, everything was on the fly. Everything was like, all right, we're going to get this board. All right, hopefully we're going to figure out how this board works. All right, we're going to get these cameras. You got those cameras. All right, we're going to work. All right, what are we working with? How are we breaking this down? What is the structure? That just seems what he lacked. He lacked structure. And I think they can fix it, but they did a huge mistake, I believe. And their huge mistake was they didn't continue. All right. My second episode was a terrible episode, but not, we were a little bit more structured, but we didn't know how to say shit without offending people. Our second episode, we talked about my friend Samantha. No, all right. So we talked about my cousin Kev and Samantha, and we were making a joke, but the thing was, we didn't do it right. So we were like, okay, we were kind of bigging up Kevin, and it made it seem like we were downplaying Samantha. So I was like, all right. It was a learning experience. I was like, all right. I went back, reviewed it. I was like, no, that sounds terrible. All right, so we can't just go throughout this whole thing. And me and C's ended up having like creative issues around this because he wanted to leave it in. I was like, I'm not going to like, and my friend doesn't want that on the episode that we're talking about our friend. Then I wanted to pull it out. So it was like a whole thing. So it was like a learning experience going on what it's like to work with more people versus what it's like to work by yourself, being in a group of people. And even when I was with a group of people, it took me really trying to wrap my mind around something, not really taking into consideration of what they might go home to of just having a conversation that I deemed was a regular conversation, like me talking about like my dating thing and hypothetical, what would you do with this, that? And they were like, quiet. And now as I get older and I watch it, I was like, all right, that was really stupid of me to think that I could have this conversation and not think that I would bring conflict into their homes. So yeah, podcasting, it's not easy, guys. It's not easy. You have to really figure out what you want to do. You got to know how to maneuver and not step on toes. There are times that I go on this show and I say some crazy shit and it's like, all right, I say it. You'll hear me say it. I'm like, one of these days, J. Cole is probably going to run into me. If he ever hears it, he's going to punch me in my face. One of these days, somebody here is going to punch me in my face. The person that I'm talking about, I spoke badly about two episodes ago because of whatever reasons, but proof is in the pudding, man. Like, the reason I feel so passionate about this conversation is because when Instagram became a thing, I used to do skits. I had fun doing skits. On my original page, that's where I got most of my popularity, and then I stopped and created the On My Cool J page. Huge fucking mistake, because nobody fucking migrated from there to there. So I lost a lot of people. Podcasting, I was podcasting before podcasting was a thing. I was just doing my own radio show where I would spend an hour and a half speaking on one subject. And then I'm like, all right. And then we finally got to the podcast. Me and C started the podcast. Like, all right. And then I transformed it into something else. And now it's like, okay, now is this creation that I have here. So yeah, to think that you would just get into this lane and think it's easy is a wild thing. It's a wild thing, especially when you're already on a bigger network and you're not paying attention to what's going on in the backgrounds of that. Yeah, having the access to see the way things can be done, the equipment, what's the best thing, and you're still not taking notes. Having an actual producer go in your show and can do the audio. You know, my biggest complaint, shout out to Parks Music, because Parks Music makes the Joe Budden podcast sound amazing. I know Joe Rogan's on top, but the Joe Budden podcast audio is magnificent. And that's all I ever strive to be, is try to get it to the level of where Parks has his audio. So when I saw the airing of this guy's show and I heard that Parks was behind it, I'm like, Parks wouldn't allow something like that to happen unless this was just rushed. There wasn't enough preparation. That's what I feel. That's a fucking genius. He's a fucking genius at fucking audio shit. He's amazing. I'm not just talking just to talk. That dude is amazing. You go listen to the Joe Budden podcast. Go listen to the way the music sounds when he plays it. Listen to the way they talk. Listen to Joe's bravado on the, like, there's like, I could raise my voice and get really high. And to me, like, I still sound like, I feel like I'm underwater with my audio. And I'll just do little twinks every now and there to fix it. But still, I can never get it to this guy's audio. And it's like, those are the things that people like that take for granted. And I get really mad sometimes when I see people that celebrities, like, oh, you're going to do a podcast? That's cool. That's cool. And then they find out real quick, like, oh, no, I can't do this shit. I don't know the first thing about this shit. Well, you're in a position to actually find out, as opposed to somebody that was like, in my position, was like, all right, we're going to run it. We're going to gun it. The biggest thing, the biggest issue when me and C's broke up on the show, I'm like, I don't know what cameras to use. This was my first camera that I used for the podcast, where I was like, all right, you can ask C's. And he'll be like, I was like, we need a camera. We need a third camera. I was like, well, I have a little Coolpix camera. And he was like, fuck it, we'll make it work. And I was like, yeah, I'm doing something. I had to go get this camera. This fucking camera cost me like $600. This camera cost me like $300. This GoPro cost me like $500. And I'm like, all right. And it was like all these things. I had to go buy a laptop that cost me like $1,000. This interface that at the time when we bought it was about $1,200, $1,300. And it's like everything just ended up adding up. And it was like, all right, we did the best that we could at the time. And then we adjusted that these lights are fucking $30 to $40 a pop. It's like, yo, mic stand, $130. This wire is $40. This microphone's $200. The filter, this pop filter right here, $60. Everything ends up. This little camera mount that's holding that is money. That's money. This is money. It's like the stands that are holding the camera, it's money. It's everything's just money. And it was like, all right. And to see these people that just got put into a position out of nowhere, it's like, all right, we're going to make this shit work. And it's like, all right. And then it didn't work. All right, we can just go away. I can't walk away from this. I have too much invested. Fucking crazy, son. So, yeah, it's just wild. Like, yeah. And then shout out to the Hawk Tua girl. This is for her. Because when you get your 15 minutes of fame, you're supposed to jump on it. See, I mentioned a couple of episodes ago about the hook to a girl. I was like, yo, the reason I like her so much is her character. Her character's funny. A lot of people find her like, oh, she's really milking it. No, she has personality. And what they told her was, since you have so much personality, we'll back you to go do a podcast right now. That's one of the highest streaming podcasts right now. And that's what it is. You have to bring something to the table, like personality. Now, my personality is my own thing. But if you're already in a position to win and you don't do the best on your winning, that's crazy, son. That's crazy. But shout out to us podcasters that really started from the ground up. A lot of us ain't make it. A lot of us did not make it. A lot of us struggled. A lot of us still struggling to get lucky, to get to catch that one lick. But if you keep in there, eventually it will hit. Shout out to Gremlin Gang. Shout out to Not So Air Jordan. I just saw his video and he's talking about stepping away for a minute. And I'm like, man, bring your ass back, right? Because the minute you take a break, I've been lucky enough that all the breaks that I've taken, that I was able to come back. Because there was times I didn't think I was going to come back. That shit was crazy, son. But, man, you got to rough it out. You got to rough it sometimes. And hopefully things work out. Let's go and get out of this section and go into... Welcome back to Part-Time Lover. Shout out to the people that fast forward to this section because they like the drama. They like the messiness. They like all that stuff. Shout out to you guys, all right? About you guys, this show doesn't get as much of the views as we normally would get. Because I remember when I made Part-Time Lover, I didn't think Part-Time Lover was going to be a hit. And then it just like, oh, shit. This is actually doing something. It's actually moving the needle. So thank you, guys. So let me select this and have Siri talk to you guys.
I was doing some messing around last week.
Hey.
And I fucked around and chipped my tooth making out with a girl at the bar. Crazy thing is that I didn't notice until the next day mostly because I was drunk. But I'm getting the feeling my girl isn't buying my story on how I lost the tooth. How can I convince her into helping me pay to get a replacement?
Oh boy, over the top! How outre.
That was some wild shit. I did not expect that turn to take the turn that it took. That was some wild shit. How can I get my girl to pay for my tooth that I chipped while I was cheating on her? Yes, people, making out is cheating, all right? Anything with anybody else that isn't your partner is fucking cheating. And if you ask your girl talking to another girl is cheating, all right? Spending too long talking to the waitress is cheating, all right? Smiling at a person that smiles back to you is cheating. Saying God bless you to somebody that's sneezing is cheating, all right? All right, all right, all right, all right. So, yeah, you're actually cheating. And you want her to fit the bill. Where is it? Where is it?
You piece of shit.
That shit is crazy to me. You want her to fit the bill. Where is your shame?
Dishonor on you! Dishonor on your family!
I'm over here looking at you like, where's your...
I'm your conscience.
Where is it? It's not there. It's not there. That's crazy trying to get your girl to pay the bill off of your cheating. Go get the other girl to pay the bill. That's crazy. You're going to cheat on your girl, look at her in her eyes. The woman that loves you and be like,
help me, help me.
After you're cheating. That's crazy shit. How hard was that kiss that you chipped your tooth? That must have really hurt. You guys must have been really shit faced and just, God damn. I think I've done that once. That shit hurt. That shit hurted. But yeah, man. Fam, if you don't fuck around, if you don't get a chiclet and glue that shit onto your fucking teeth, that's some crazy shit. Trying to get your girl to fit the bill for your cheating. Wow. What's a rat?
Nay, I do not jest like that. I do not jest like that.
No, you frolic too much.
Because if you didn't chip your tooth on her, man, did it stop the...
Fuck two and spit on that thing.
Did it stop that? Probably not. Damn, son. She's not buying it? Because how else would you chip your tooth? How bad is the chip? Is the whole shit missing or is it just like a corner piece? You look like NAS is the letters that spell? That's some wild shit. Why are you leading the kiss with your teeth first? That's another one. That's another one. You're wiling. Wiling, 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 wiling. Mm-mm-mm. Did you find your tooth? That's a better question. That's a better question. Because she'll go find your tooth. She's going to go look for evidence. Like, what is this lipstick on this broken tooth on the floor? Then she's going to match it to your teeth, right? She's going to do it like Cinderella with a slipper. But with your tooth, she's like, all right, who does this tooth belong to? Perfect fit. That's crazy, son. That is crazy. Have you no shame trying to get her to pay for your tooth? And she's not buying it. Right now, she's not. She's like...
No! You cannot trick me.
That's crazy, son. You couldn't cheat with a dentist or a girl that's a dental hygienist? How would I react if I made out off a girl and I chipped her tooth or my teeth? Am I paying for it? I don't think so. I do not think so. We're going down to the local Walgreens and buying some tooth glue, all right? Or we're getting you, yo. Having a false front tooth must be crazy, son. Because I know that shit don't stay on. Because all I think about is Dame Dash when he had his whole shit pop off. His whole dentures just fall out. So that's crazy. That is some crazy shit. Stop being a piece of shit, all right?
You suck!
All right, don't do that to your girl, all right? Or your future ex. That's crazy. The nerve to ask me how to get you some points.
My girl's brother is getting out in. He wants to stay with us until he gets it together. I'm telling her fuck no, he's a criminal, and don't want out kids near him. Help me convince her to get him to stay somewhere else. His mom lives in Philly, go stay there.
No, you're absolutely right. You are absolutely right. Here it is. Those are the warning signs. That's coming up. That is not good. What button is this?
Damn,
oh, I'm not saying that. Hell no. Hell no. I don't know what his charges are. Got to get rid of that one for the brands. But, nah, man. Let him figure that shit. Go to a halfway house. I heard, what's his name? Fuck, what's his name? I heard Meech's halfway house is nice. Go over there. Stop playing. Stop playing, all right? Nah, man, you can't stay here. You can't stay here at all. I'm over here trying to... If I get home off of a long day, do a nice 30, 40 minutes in traffic, get home to my girl. She's not in the best of moods. But I could get her out of that mood, possibly get a little...
Puck to and spit on that thing.
Get her a little riled up. Take it to the living room. And then his punk ass is there? Nah. No. That's when you gotta look at your girl in the face and be like,
I love you. I wanna take you away from all of this.
Yeah, get away from your family. Yeah, go tell him to stay with his mom. Go to Philly. Shit. Meek Mill's doing a great reform Diddy act over there. Shit, stop playing around. All right? You also don't know what kind of man he was in there. You don't. Man could have been a booty warrior, a booty bandit. You over here putting your life at risk. Your wife. Women just be putting guys in the worst positions, all right? The worst positions. Trying to set him up to put me in. Let me stop. But yeah. It's not.
Barry Demur.
It's not. It's not at all. Just be vocal about that. Like, I don't know, we're not letting a fucking convict that ran our child, all right? I'm having my, if you guys have kids, I'm not letting my kids around no convicted fidelins, all right, okay? What kind of example would I be setting if I let this criminal come stay with our family? Right? Right? If we have kids, I'm putting them in danger by having this criminal in the house. Nope. Complete deal breaker. Now my horns go up. I'm going, no. No. All right. No. Sorry. Tell them, go to Philly. All right. Go to fucking, what's the name of that place? Scranton, Pennsylvania. All right. Go be a, over there. All right. Go be a burner to somebody else. Shit. I know that sounds rude. I know that sounds mean, but no. Too grown for that shit. Too grown. He's going to probably, if he's on probation, he has to use that address as the probation. He has to stay there for a minute. And if he wants to make accommodations to go stay somewhere else, then that's going to take a minute for that to do. No. Hell no. No. There goes your answer right there. Thank you for submitting your questions to Part-Time Lover. We're out of that section. All right, guys, I want to end this show by saying thank you to everybody that listened to this. Thank you if you made it this far. I apologize if you didn't find me entertaining and you left. I hate to see you guys go. But most of all, I just want to say shout out to everybody out there that's doing their thing, that's out there hustling, setting up goals, knocking down their goals. Hopefully you achieve your goal and you set up another goal because you don't want to be stagnant. And if you get knocked down, get your punk ass up. All right. The world's not going to stop for you, so you got to get your ass back up and keep moving. Yeah. All right, guys. You guys have been great. Truly fucks with y'all. All right. I have been your regular degular host, Jose Luis, a.k.a.
On My Cool J.
And I'm out of here. Peace out.